Dr. Jackson, man, I'm stressing, bro. It's too much going on. I'm seeing all these successful people. I don't even know if they believe.
Calm down. Have a seat.
I need to talk to somebody.
Well, you're in the right place. Have a seat. Now tell me, what's going on in your mind?
I think I'm going crazy.
Going crazy? Yeah, mental hospitalization. Don't mind him, he is my apprentice. Well, we're gonna count to seven. When I count to seven, I want you to close your eyes. And in the midst of closing your eyes, you're gonna wake up in a brand new state of mind. But you have to go through these visions in order to change yourself. Are you ready?
I'm ready, Dad.
All right, here we go. Let's start. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Too flashy, y'all shouldn't have let the world gas me. It's too late cause I'm here to stay, and these girls know that I'm nasty. I sent her back to her boyfriend with my handprint on her ass cheek. City talking, we taking notes. Tell him all to keep making posts. Wish he could, but he can't get close. OG's so proud of me that he choking up while he making toast. I'm the type that you can't control. Said I would, then I made it so. I don't clear up rumors. Where's y'all sense of humor? I'm done making jokes cause they got old like baby boomers. Turn my haters to consumers. I make vets feel like they juniors. Say your time is coming soon, but just like Oklahoma, mine is coming sooner. I'm just a late bloomer. I done peak in high school, I'm still out here getting cuter.
Cool, so thank you guys for supporting on another episode of the Notyouraveragesuccessstory movement. I got another dope guest today, man, and I'm very excited because this one is a little different. I think I would like to consider it a little different just because I kind of seen bro's evolution, and I think that you will find it just as interesting, if not more interesting than I. So, without further ado, bro, can you introduce yourself a little bit? Let us know a little bit about you, where you're from, an interesting fact.
So, yeah, my name is David Walker. Originally, I was born in New Orleans by me. I call Laura home because okay. I mean, this kind of where I got my start with music, period. So like, I'm okay. always call Laura home. Okay. Always. Okay. Interesting fact.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I mean, I think what you do is very interesting.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. Just doing, I mean, just all the stage stuff. I mean, not just stage. I mean, any type of singing, whether it's okay. like pop. Like, I just did the Utah thing, and okay. I was, like, opera-related, and then, like, I did some stuff with Festival South in Hattiesburg.
So it says Utah Vocal?
Yeah, Utah Vocal Arts Academy.
So can you elaborate a little bit more about that?
Okay, so that was, so it's basically, like, they call them, like, pay to sings. And so, okay. like, I had to pay to go to the academy, and, like, you had master classes. You got two fully staged operas. You had coachings, okay. acting classes, and okay. did all of that for a month.
So 30 days straight?
Yeah, but, well, not quite 30 days. It was July 5th to July 31st.
Okay,
yeah.
okay. So in what you do, so take sports, for instance. Yeah. You have different positions, quarterback, running back, whatever, lineman. In the arts, or is it even considered the arts, or is it more so?
Yeah, it's okay. considered the arts.
So in the arts, is there a specific position that you hold?
I mean, not really. I guess you could say I'm a performer.
Okay.
But I mean,
okay,
you can. I mean, but it really all depends on like what you want to do and what you decide to immerse yourself into.
Okay. Okay.
Honestly.
Okay. Where were you, I guess, where are you more specifically in it, in the arts or however you would?
I would say definitely performance.
Performance?
Yeah, because all of the, we did a Motown show in Hattiesburg in June. Okay. Like, I've done Nat King Cole stuff, I've done like operas, musical theater.
Okay.
So it's like, it's a lot of different things, but I just like to, but I mean, I like learning about different types of styles of music too.
Okay. Do you have someone that you specifically look up to that I guess has came up in the arts? Because like I said, for me, and I'm sure a lot of other people, I'm not familiar with it. So like, is there someone that I could, I guess, pinpoint or look at like, okay, this is kind of where bro is going or where he is aspiring to be?
I know people that I look at like, just for me, like musical theater, I said, like, or any type of music, like a Leslie Odom Jr.
Once I lived a life of a millionaire, spending my money, I didn't care. Always taking my friends out for a good time. Spending every nickel on gin and cheap wine. But just as soon as my dough got low, I couldn't find a friend nor a place to go.
Okay. Or like an opera, Eric Owens, like great, okay. Okay. great baritone.
Okay, okay.
And he's done a lot of really good things, and they did like they did a Porgy and Bess, which is like an all black opera that they did at the Met, and he was the lead baritone in that role.
Okay.
Figures like that, like they're very, very good at what they do. Ooh, Lawrence Brownlee.
Okay.
Great, great Rossini tenor. He is really, really good. Like, dude is, he is the guy.
Yeah.
L'amor che va torna la tête. Désormais, désormais, me rendrai.
a quel poder qui me se mi je ve ma chez sous votre rapport je ve ma chez sous votre rapport.
Yeah, what, so I guess singing wise, or do you have a specific I heard you say tenor and different things like that. Do you have a specific place where you stay?
I mean, I've been classified as, like, I guess I'm technically like a tenor, but I consider myself a singer.
Oh. Dear Theodosia, what to say to you? You had my eyes, you had your mother's name. When you came into the world, you cried, and it broke my heart. I'm dedicating every day to you. Domestic life was never quite my style. When you smile, you knocked me out, I fell apart, and I thought I was so smart. You will come a page with our young nation. We'll bleed and fight for you, we'll make it right for you. If we lay a strong enough foundation, on to you, we'll give the world to you, and you'll blow us all away. Someday, someday, yeah, you'll blow us all away. Someday, someday.
Okay.
And that's just it.
So you know, have a favorite music artist?
No, not really.
Okay,
Because, I just like to listen to so many different types of music.
Any specific music or just all types?
Really all. I feel like there's something that can be found and learned in really any type of music. That's if you give it a chance.
That's powerful. Do you do instruments or anything?
I used to. When I was at Jones, I used to play tuba and euphonium.
Okay.
In a band.
Bro, it sounds like you are a jack of many trades. Many trades. Well, shoot, bro, I appreciate that. Like I said, that's definitely very interesting. So I guess now we can kind of discuss, is there something specific that you feel like, you know, in your life that you have had to overcome, currently overcoming? Something along those lines.
I would say for me, and this has always been a struggle for me, and I feel like for a lot of people, is mental dexterity.
Okay.
In anything, in sports, in music, in anything that you're trying to strive to get to something, there's always going to be obstacles, and there's always going to be things that you have to get over, trying to get over the hump. And sometimes some obstacles may be bigger than others, and it can get really, really tough.
Yeah.
But those are those tests.
Yeah. It's
like the universe is testing you that, hey, you can get over this, then, you know, you can handle.
Yeah.
You can handle much bigger things.
Yeah.
And the horizon is much bigger.
So you said mental, what's the word again?
Dexterity.
Could you I've personally never heard that word.
So it's like akin to strength. Like
okay.
mental strength to be able to, you know, because I mean, like, take school for instance, college. Sometimes people don't graduate college.
Yeah.
I almost didn't graduate college.
Yeah.
You know? And it takes mental dexterity, it takes will to do it. Because sometimes, because it's harder for some people.
So did you cling to a work, did you find that was able to give you that strength too? You know, when you, I guess you were dealing with whatever it is that you're speaking on.
I know for me, I tend to, like, when things tend to get hard, I kind of have tunnel vision, and like, I'll just like, I'm consistently trying to do whatever I gotta do, but I kind of like just not mean to ignore people but you know, you just
Bro,
be so focused.
It's great, and that's so important that you're saying that, because a lot of people, I think, I don't know why, I don't know if it's just our community or the community in general, but people deem laser focusing, people deem basically when you get focused and kind of ignore, I guess you can consider it ignoring others, they deem it as a negative thing. Like, I feel like it's so important for a person to be able to quiet everything around them and become in tune with themselves before even trying to impress someone else or doing anything else. Because if you don't if you don't address you, then you it's really a ticking time bomb. So, like I said, it's beautiful that you're speaking on that, because, like I said, it's so weird. Like I hear more negative comments toward people taking time to themselves, and again, they would consider it not messing with others, versus right. like, well, I'm actually proud of you for doing that, because, like, I know that I've been through that journey too, and it's a process.
Yeah, it's a big process.
It's not easy.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I think people, that stigma is created from people not going through their process and not realizing, you know, just how essential it is and just how tough it is as well. So they just, oh, you're being weird. You know, why are you not talking to us? You know what I'm saying? Why are you not being around? But like I said, it's really that's a battle. I tell people all the time, man. Like, they ask me, like, I had someone ask me the other day, what's the toughest part about doing this? And one thing that sticks out, because it's a lot, but one thing that sticks, bro, is the mental battle. You know, I think this is so positive. You know, I think me being able to talk to you and you sharing your experiences and you hearing me out, like, that's what, you know, that's what life is about.
Right.
You know, sharing experiences.
Right.
As positive as I see this, there will be a time where obviously you're going to go home. You're going to go back to your life. I'm thinking, oh my God, this is so dope. But then life is going to play its part.
Life continues.
Bro, life is going to do what it does.
It does what it does.
And it's going to get in my head. So as much as I'm thinking this is, life is still going to do what it does. And, you know, if you can, again, just quiet life, even quiet this experience, and like really just get in tune with just how precious it is. Mm-hmm. And then, like I said, just utilize this experience with whatever life is throwing you, and just quiet it out and just choose what, you know what I'm saying, what's going on here. It's hard.
Yeah, and on the other side of that, you know, when you're doing that, sometimes it can get to a point where, like, you get into an impasse.
Yeah.
And things get stuck. And
yeah.
A big thing for me is, like, having that growth inside myself to, you know, whenever I'm down, let somebody help you up.
Yeah.
And it's not that I would purposely not want to ask people for help.
Yeah.
But you know how it is. You wanna get out there and get it yourself.
Pride.
But you let that pride get in the way. Yeah, and it's like, you know, I had to take a step back, and I was like, bruh, what are you doing? Let people help you out. And it made my life easier, and it helped make me stronger. Mm-hmm. Knowing that, you know, like, you're not alone, man.
That's dope.
Yeah.
I had a question for you, bro. So did you know, going into the arts, did you know going into it that people would, because it's crazy, like I said, I'll pay attention to you, and I've seen, like, when you would post certain things, like, people are really, like, excited and like interacting positively towards it. Did you know that would come?
I mean,
or was it a shock?
It was a shock. I mean, it really was, because I mean, like, growing up, I was singing like in my room.
Yeah.
Like, I wouldn't, like, sing. I'll sing out sometimes. Like, my mom always sang. She always sang me as a kid. All my brothers. And I mean, I would sing sometimes too, but I wouldn't do it like that. But I'd be in my room, I'd be singing, doing all type of stuff. And then get to high school, and I was like, you know, all my friends was in choirs. I was like, mm-hmm. I might as well get in. I like singing,
mm-hmm.
and so I got myself into that.
Mm-hmm.
And then it kind of just spiraled out into, you know, wanting to learn so many new different things about you know, all this. Because, like, the stuff we were doing, and I mean, we did like a lot of gospel stuff, select choir.
Yeah, yeah.
But then I remember this one thing. It was it was in, like, Latin, and which I found out later was a madrigal.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't know what it was, but I was like, this is really cool. And then once I got to Jones, we were doing that type of music.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, oh. And so that kind of, like, having that one little experience of that right there, like, helped me, and it made me think, like, dang, like, there are so many different types of music out there that's really interesting.
Yeah. So Ingo, are you wanting to? What are you? Because you opened my mind right now. I feel like it's so much out there. Like, are you wanting to be something specific, or like, what does it look like for you? So how old are you right now?
I'm 26. 26.
5 years. 31. What does it look like for you? Ideally, what would you want it to be?
5 years, 31. I mean, ideally, I want to be successful as a musician.
Yeah.
Like going out doing performances, whether it be like doing cruise ships, whether I'm like doing like a national tour, whether I'm on Broadway, whether I'm doing something for opera, like if I'm overseas.
Yeah.
I'm recording like anything, because I feel confident enough in what I do and the different types of music that I've done. I feel like I can really do anything. I feel like as long as I just put myself out there, I can be successful. So yeah, just out doing things.
That's
the big thing, just getting out doing things.
You honestly just got to do it. A lot of people overthink it and stress themselves, one, because it's not what they envision right now. Mm-hmm. But they're missing the whole point, you know. And if she doesn't talk about it, it's a marathon. You know, you just keep going. You know what I'm saying?
I
am a firm believer, and I had to come, like, and I understand wholeheartedly how hard it is, because at one point, again, I'm like, oh my God, this is so positive. I'm talking to people and different things like that. And I'm like, why isn't it moving how I want it to right now?
Right.
And I just had to, you know, I just came to a conclusion one day, and like, I mean, it was through conversation and research. I read a lot and different things like that, and just understanding that, one, faith is big, especially specifically, I can't speak for anybody else.
Right.
Faith is big when it comes to investing your time, energy, money into something. And if you just keep doing it and you're getting better, eventually, you know, something has to happen.
You put too much time and energy towards this thing. Like, something has to happen. Something has to happen.
I don't know what it will be. I have an idea, and that's the part of manifesting. You know what I'm saying? I write. Like, literally, it's crazy. Prior to coming here, like, so I live in Nebraska now.
Yeah.
I wrote this down last year that I was going to come here. And I was going to talk to people, and it's dope. You're like a part of my manifestation. You know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't know who I was going to talk to. It's crazy because there's a whole story behind that, because I had so many different people that reached out initially.
Yeah.
Bro, it's okay. This is crazy. I had so many different people reach out initially, and I came off the strength of people's word. A lot of people's word. When I got here, a lot of those different people didn't respond. Mm. You were an individual, I can't remember if I reached out or you reached out, but we connected, and you actually came through. And like, that goes back to that conversation about the mental. Me coming here off other people's word, life, is putting a negative, you know, space in my head, because I'm just like, dang, like, I came off of, like, this is why I'm here, you know, outside of seeing my family, I came here for that. But then again, I said, like, I can get here and I'm talking to you. I didn't think I was going to be talking to you, but you're a part. I try to look at everything like I've tricked my mental into, even in a negative situation, I find something positive.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because I can harp on, man, dang, they ain't hitting me up, dang, like, I really came here. And I can manifest that negative energy.
Yes, yes, that is key, dog.
Bro,
that's key.
And then people will wonder why they're upset or bothered. Right. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Bro, if you just really just, you don't, you choose, you really chose to be upset. You know what I'm saying? But like I said, I choose to stay positive, and I look at this man, and like I said, bro, I haven't seen you in years, and I'm able to sit here. And like I said, I'm dead serious when I say I've been watching you on Facebook, bro. Like, and seeing your success just build, and I'm just like, and I'm not only excited, but I see other people excited. So I was like, I have to talk to him. Like, I have to look this man in his eyes. I really want to shake his hand and let him know that I'm proud of him. You know what I'm saying? It's not that I couldn't tell you that in high school, but I don't even remember us being in a similar situation to where I think, you know what I'm saying? Because again, I really remember you being very quiet. I don't remember you talking at all. Now I'm seeing you just out here, bro, just boastful and just proud and just and doing amazing. Like you actually great. Like you're doing an amazing job. And I just wanted to, like I said, man, be in your presence because like energy is powerful, bro. And what you're doing is amazing. And I can only get more positive energy from you, you know what I'm saying, being around you. So yeah, I have one more question. How is the community in the arts? Like, is that like, are they receptive of other people that are in it? Is it a hierarchy? Is it like,
how? I mean, I would definitely say once you get to more corporate level stuff, yeah, and like higher up in the industry, is there's definitely a lot.
Yeah.
But I would say it's especially like for the community, like Hattiesburg, for example. Like, I love the community in Hattiesburg, mm-hmm, and like they're very invested in the arts. Mm-hmm. Like from the community to like the mayor, the administration, like they're also invested into the arts, which is really, really cool to see. Mm-hmm. Because a lot of times people like that tend to put it on the back burner.
Yeah.
But to see like a full city, you know, fully invested and embrace the arts is really cool. Yeah.
Bro, so I have a younger brother. I don't know. He's actually, he does a lot in this community as far as with the arts. I don't know nothing about it. For people coming up, his name is Jordan Hardy. Have you ever heard of him? I had to show you a picture. For kids coming up or other individuals that may be interested in the arts, what type of advice would you give them, you know, based off of the journey that you have traveled?
I would say when it comes to the arts, especially like if you want to like school for it or something like that, biggest thing, keep an open mind. That keeping an open mind has really opened my eyes to things that I never thought that I would see, that I would never thought I would experience. Mm-hmm. Keeping an open mind and just staying in the path. Mm-hmm. That's,
and it'll all just
usually if you stay the path and you really like, you have full conviction in your heart, like, this is what I want to do.
Yeah.
Like, you're going to be successful.
Yeah.
Is things will happen.
Yeah.
They have to happen.
Yeah. Well, dang, bro, I feel like you kind of said it all. Is there anything else that you want to hit on? Is there anything else that you want to highlight? You know, you don't necessarily have to, but I always want to give that opportunity just in case.
I'd say, especially like in, like what I do, like as far as like the opera musical theater thing, especially since the George Floyd incident happened, it's been a lot of highlight in the arts community about, you know, inclusion for BIPOC, like LGBT and all that other stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And there are there's been headway made, but there's still like a long way to go. But I feel like if more people take the time to just, like I said, just have an open mind.
Yeah.
Just, you know, get out and do some different things. You might like it.
Yeah.
You know? I think we can continue to make headway.
Yeah.
To where things can be, you know, comfortable for people. And people don't feel excluded.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Cool. Well, bro, again, I appreciate it, man. I think that was dope. It's definitely what I expected, and I think it was a little higher than what I expected. Like I said, I feel your energy, you know what I'm saying? And it was very positive, and I really enjoyed it. But if there is nothing else, man, this is another episode of the Notyouraveragesuccessstory Movement. Thank you guys for supporting the Notyouraveragesuccessstory Movement. I really hope that you enjoyed the episode. There was a lot of time, energy, and effort spent with making this a successful moment, not only for the guest, but for myself and everybody else. And I hope that you enjoyed the episode as much as I did, and look forward to another beautiful episode next week on the Notyouraveragesuccessstory platform. thank you again, because this movement would not be successful without you and your support. So big thank you from the bottom of my heart. Please continue to support. Also, subscribe. So, thank you guys. Peace, love, and chicken grease.